I want to talk about a topic that's very troublesome, very, very hard to do. The programming is very difficult, and and often it does not succeed. It doesn't matter who is doing it. The person has to be deprogrammed out of drugs or cults or religious fanaticism or homosexuality or pedophilia, or they really, really have to want to change on their own, or usually some kind of spiritual awakening. And if somebody else comes around and says, hey, you know, a lot of these behaviors you got is very troublesome, then that person is likely to get his ass kicked in the beginning, and then later on, with a lot of difficulty, they might just, these people might just say, well, yeah, this could be troublesome, this could be wrong, but it's okay, the society has accepted. In fact, the U.S. society has decriminalized many status crimes the status crime, if you commit a crime against yourself, like if you buy a high caliber weapon and load it up and shoot yourself in the head, and nobody really can do anything about it, and you know that somebody else is not going to come along and wrestle that gun out of your hand, you know, risk his own life and limb just to save you. I mean, so the decisions have to come from your inner self, and that's the sad thing about deprogramming, or a lot of recovery, a lot of you know, camps that deal with reprogramming or re-educating people to give up false beliefs. It don't work, and the recidivism is very high. I think with drugs, hard drugs, the rate of the people that succeed and they give up heroin or other drugs is very low. It's like when they get into a program, it's like 2%, or I don't know, I heard it from some people, it's like below 10%. I'm thinking it's more like 5-6% of all the people that go in, and we humans, we get addicted to so many things that in Arabic language, the name for humans is insan, and comes from the root word ons. Ons means like getting addicted, getting used to something. Insan means like the animal that gets addicted to anything and everything. So there's a lot of hints in the Islamic literature. Well, I had a video, it was called What the Universe Wants. It's like the God or universe, whoever built this machine or this addictive creature, she programmed her or him in a way that that what she wants, like in the Bible it says that God wanted to get the crop out of a land where he had just thrown some seeds around without watering it or taking care of it. It was just seeds that he haphazardly throwed around, So basically what this passage is saying is that there is like an inner self, inner code. The Muslim word for it is fitra, is your inner essence. And then there's all the shit that happens in your day, in your personal life, and you get addicted to it, or they become significant when they weren't supposed to be. Like when kids get abused, that child or children get abused, then these experiences become magnified as they grow older. They become all kinds of characters. But what the biblical passage is saying, or the word fitra means, which God wanted the crowd without making any effort on his part. He wanted you to struggle like fuck to get rid of all this stuff that aren't supposed to be there and bring out what is supposed to be there. It's like, it's like cutting back on things that you know they're not gonna come out to be anything good. It's like you have a farm and you cut out the weeds, the stuff that's not supposed to be there, to let the real crop come out, the real spiritual body. But in practice, a lot of rehabs, they don't work. But what works is often a cocktail therapy of cutting back chemical or other dependencies, and then also with this a lot of spiritual practices and rejuvenation. And when you go into the Sufi school, usually in a lot of temples, they have these words. And this is the sentence that the first Sufi master uttered, and it's really important to the Sufis. It says, "Aleika beqalbuka," to you return to your own heart, to your own essence, to your own what you were supposed to be, what you were supposed to grow up to become. If you hadn't really screwed yourself up with drugs or violence, or if nothing had gone wrong, then this essence, this is what you were supposed to do in the beginning. There is a lot of references to these ideas in Christianity and in Quran, in Sufism. There's another passage I know from Bible. It was about Christ. He was hungry. He was walking in the country or the desert, and he comes across a fig tree, and it was the season for this tree to give fruits, and he had none to offer, and he was hungry. So Jesus said that you didn't do really what nature wanted you to do. This was your time to offer fruit to the Lord, and he didn't do it. So what's the use of you? And the tree withered and died away. It was a useless piece of crap. It didn't do what it was supposed to, what was the essence of it. So I've seen the courts, they try to do some type of deprogramming, like diversion programs, or this process of jury, try to get people who are contemporaries, or people who are from the same town where somebody had committed crime. They are of the same culture, but they're not criminals, they're ordinary people. So the same sets of values exist, but they are more in their right way, in their more spiritual, more what the society wants or accepts. And so the courts, they try to bring these kinds of people to judge and help the person see what they did that was wrong. And the other thing that the courts try to do, or even the warden tries to do, is like they put somebody who has done something very minor in jail for a few days. They put them with somebody that, well, they usually don't do it just one-on-one. It would be like three, four of the guys have lower level crimes with somebody who has done something very bad. And then kind of like in this interaction, this person might get a perspective of what society is doing. And there is also a saying in the Muslim that God is in the group, in the, like a bunch of people, where God shows up too, because there each one is a piece of a puzzle, incomplete, and then when they all get together, the spirit is there. You follow what I'm saying? And then also, I don't think the group psychology is really the same thing as the spirit being there, but it does have a healing aspect to it. It's because the person, he's confronted with other people who do not have this hang-up, and it's kind of like, he or she feels completed, in even though momentarily, and then when they go back to their own self or alone, they got a picture of, they got a complete picture that conflicts with their own criminality or their own hang-ups. Anyhow, there's some stuff. I did study some deep programming, but mostly with just literature. But another thing that the Sufi master said, that if God wanted to create us all together, like we're all in little cults and little, we are attached to each other, so attached that we can't get away, then he would just have attached our limbs and our brains together too, with the pipes going on. And whereas in the modern society, you know, most people, when they go past the age of 15, 16, they're able to work, they're able to eat by themselves, they're able to drive a car, they're able to attend rehab, they're able to go to college or to school. So the only reason that we engage in social interaction is to find a mate, or to or humans are social animals, we need the other people. But this need is something limited. And if it becomes an addiction, then you can sit aside and you know, do something else, because you really, you do not need it. It's just some form of recreation, some kind of addiction, some kind of thing that can get out of hand. There is a lot of social diseases too, but I don't know. Why this doesn't work, the programming doesn't work. Because when people are in that mode, when they are very addicted to a cult or to a drug, I think what irritates these people a great deal when they come in contact with somebody who is just living their normal life and don't need that thing so much, it's like they kind of get it. Hey, I'm messing with this thing, and here's another guy, he's just going about his life, or another girl, and what am I doing this? What am I doing wrong? Why am I so fucked up? This is another guy just like me. It's a very contagious. I think the courts, or I think AA or NA people, they kind of know about this, and in Christianity they call this the discipleship. I don't know, Alcoholics Anonymous, they call it sponsorship. Like when somebody, older recovered alcoholic, sponsors the new one, and the new one sees the old one doesn't need all this stuff and goes about his life, it just something clicks in right. This is a very valuable technique of deprogramming, and there is a lot of hints and little comments about this in Sufism. Well, actually, the Sufi master has a picture, and the picture it says Al-Faqir, this Sadiq Anga, which means the poor Sadiq Anga, his name, his Sufi master's name. Well, this is the late Sufi master. So, but the word poverty also has a meaning, which means like not needing all these hang-ups, all these things that we get addicted to, and becoming just your own self, which is really your healthy part, the part that's got a lot of the sensitivities and spiritual qualities to it. I think Jesus says something like that too. Like he says, blessed are the poor and the peacemakers. Something like that. The word poverty also has double meaning in Christianity, which means sometimes they say when you join an order, they say you're taking the oath of poverty. I agree that we don't need a lot of this stuff, and we just gonna what doesn't always mean giving up a financial or personal effect. It does mean that you know, there is a lot of behavior that you shouldn't engage in because you have taken the oath of poverty. I think Christianity and Sufism and also Islam, they're very loaded with all these little references to these concepts or ideas. Anyhow, that's just my 2 cents worth on this subject. I get knocked around. I have to deal with a lot of this stuff. I think God wants to punish me, and then he kind of lets me off the hook for a little bit, and then I'm back again dealing with another issue. Well, thank you for being in my YouTube channel, and my stuff is research. You do need to have certain intellectual and spiritual finesse to even get this stuff. Thank you.